Hi. I'm not sure if I've done a throwing video here in the new studio. This is the kitchen of the little mother-in-law house that I've got in my backyard. So I've transformed it into a studio. It still needs a lot of work, but I have to use the space as I can. So I'm not gonna worry about the renovations. I'm just gonna get work done. So I'm throwing speckled buff Michigan mugs today, and the bag that I've got is kind of squishy, so the squishier balls just have to be thrown slower. It's not a big deal. It's actually a lot easier on my hands to have softer clay. So anyway, I'm gonna start throwing. I'll probably talk at you while I'm at it. So pardon my cough. I'm not sure what's up with that. Lovely. Alright. So these are approximately 1 pound pieces. I'm lazy. I don't weigh my clay. I take a 25-pound bag and I cut it into a certain number of equally sized pieces. So I measure and cut rather than weigh. So a 25-pound bag gets cut into 24 pieces because that's easy. That's what I work with for the smaller mugs. Larger mugs and bowls get a pound and a half, which is 16 pieces rather than 24 for a bag. Oh, heck. The ball came loose from the bat, so I just convinced it wanted to stay on. It's not really how you're supposed to do it, but you know. Whatever. I haven't thrown in a while. It's been cold out here. Cold isn't nice to my joints and hands, so I've been trying to get stuff done. I've been dealing with a lot of fatigue issues, so I've been doing a lot of sleeping and resting, which is not great for the productivity, let me tell ya. Okay, that's finally centered. That one wasn't as squishy as the first one that I threw. That one was super squishy. Okay. Start my opening. And I'm going to use my handy dandy bottom gauge tool here. These legs are longer than the middle leg. And so I push it down, push this down in the center until these hit the bat. And that leaves a particular thickness of bottom that I can then pull the rest of the bottom out with. The bats that I'm using right now don't like to pull out smoothly this way, so I only go about an inch. So I've got, about an inch diameter hole right now, and then I will finish opening it out, and then I'll smooth out my bottom. I do kind of open out a little wider. Well, actually, I used to. I don't so much anymore. I think I push out to pull up a little bit more than I push in, and I'm not sure why. Not really a big deal, I guess. It all works the same for me. Maybe it works a little better for me, I don't know. It gets the job done one way or the other. Okay. And that was just a little quick recenter with a squeeze, so that kind of acts as my first pull. But then I can cheat and say, no, that wasn't my first pull, that was just me opening it up. I know, you guys that aren't potters don't have any clue what I'm talking about. Okay, here's my official first pull. I'm pushing in on the outside, pushing out on the inside to just kind of squeeze the clay gently as I move it up. So squeezing it just kind of forces it upwards. Then I just have to be careful to guide it and not pinch it too hard so that it goes all the way through or makes a weak spot. So if you get it too thin, then it wants to buckle there, and then you end up with something you don't want. And many potters leave a skirt of clay on the bottom that they then trim off later. I don't like trimming, so I don't leave the skirt there at all. I use my thumbnail to clear it away as I go. And that also pushes in to create a little ridge of clay that I can pull up to make the piece taller. And I'm just measuring with my gauge stick. I use the same one for my small Michigan mugs and my small skull mugs. Height and approximate rim diameter. I haven't been measuring the rims lately, though. I've just been going basic height and calling it good, and then make it to look how I like it. It seems to work out. If I were making a bunch, you know, for somebody and they wanted it to look pretty exact, you know, have everything look very uniform, I might measure every rim and make sure that they're all the same. For souvenir mugs, it doesn't seem to make any difference. So, all right, we are at height. I'm gonna do a touch of shaping here before I do my rim. Collar in at the top. Lip grabber rim. I think it's a fun shape. Alright, we need more belly on this thing. It looks too... looks like a skinny guy with a wide neck, you know? I need to give him some more definition. There we go. Out the water on the bottom and do a quick trim and undercut and clean off the bat and the undercut at the same time. And there's that one. A nice big workroom out in the other room. It's not huge. I mean, the whole house with both floors and the porch is 600 square feet. So I use the downstairs for the studio. Upstairs, you know, we have a storage room because I still have all, you know, lots of kids in my house. We don't have any storage room in there. And I have an office and inventory storage area upstairs, which is nice. That's my wobbly one. I don't want that one. And But anyway, the living room of the house is my, you know, work room. So I've got tables out there. I've got my extruder out there. All of my stamps are stored out there. So I'm putting my pieces out on the table to firm up so that I can take them off of the bags. And then they'll sit out there on wear boards until I get the handles on them, which I also do out there. I'm gonna move the wheel out to the front porch, which is where my kiln is right now. I've got, it's equal floor space on either side of the front door, so I've got the kiln on one side, and I'll put my wheel on the other side. Which is the way I had it before it got cold here. And it was nice. It's nice and sunny out there. It's all windows, so it'll be a nice space. Maybe I'm getting this too wet and I need to just not do that. Not a very good recenter. I'm wobbling still. Psh. Whatever. Like they say, how do you remove the wobble from a thrown piece? You turn off the wheel. Then nobody can see it.
It's a little fat one.
How's that for rim?
That's a bit wide. That's all right.
It might just hold a little bit more. That one may end up being a 16-ouncer or something like that. Okay. I'm using the nifty bat system that me and my dad made. I just went and bought a big sheet of half-inch MDF, the medium density fiberboard, just from Home Depot. Took it over to my dad's and he helped me cut it up into squares. And I think I've got a video posted with how we cut out all the circles on the bandsaw with the jig that he helped me put together. And then we used a couple of them and cut a square out of the inside with drilled out holes in the corners so that we could just put a square piece so that I'm not taking up five tables out there trying to firm up all of my pieces on 12-inch bats. It's 6-inch squares. They all fit together really nicely. And it makes it so much easier to get stuff done in a smaller space. All right, this one's a squashy one, so we're not gonna go as fast. Why are you still not behaving yourself? I do not understand you. All right. It's probably me. I still can't center without looking at my clay. It doesn't seem to work, so I have to not look at it. And thankfully that works just fine. Which of course is wobbly. Yeah, whatever. I've got a torqued spot in there. I wonder if I do.
Easy does it. This is really soft. Maybe it's an air bubble in there. Let's see how it goes. As long as you can't see it on the outside, I'm not going to worry about it. Gave it thin spots. That's not good. Yes. Alright, let's see. It's probably too tall, too. It's right about there. Give it a quick trim here. I can throw some of this base up into the thin section. Yeah, it's not too bad. All right, let's give it a little bit of a belly here. Bring it in. All right. Get that smoothed over. Trim out. Give it a rim smooth with the webbing between my fingers. Out the water. I've been getting better about not needing a ton of water to throw, but I still end up with a bit in the bottom, so that's not a bad thing. I don't throw with a sponge in my hand or anything like that. I don't even use ribs. I don't like having anything in my hand when I'm working. Everybody says, oh, you just need to learn how to do it. Well, I don't wanna. I only don't do things that sound good to me, so, you know. Someday I will want to. There's always time to learn new things. Six of them down. I think I did two before I turned on the camera. I think I'll let you go after this one. Half an hour is kind of a long video, so. Oh, dang. I hate it when I don't get the middle. A little wonderful center. did it again. I hope today's not going to be a bad pottery day. I have those sometimes. Where just everything that I do is screwed up, and so I have to just go do something else. It turns into a cleaning day, or a magnet stamping day, or a carving day, or something. What I really need to be doing is taking pictures of what I took out of the kiln yesterday. But of course I haven't done that. Come on. You're super soft, you should be centering just fine. The first one was a dream. I plopped it on there. I cupped my hands over it. It went exactly where it was supposed to go. Back. Lumps in here. Squishy spots. I probably should do some tiny ones. Seems like a lot of the older folks like their coffee and tea in very moderate amounts, which I can understand. These will turn out about in the 14-ounce range. That is a little too fat. That's better.
That is also better.
Got my rhythm off. Now, if you have any questions, just leave a comment, and the next time I do a video, I'll try and remember to answer them. Or I'll just, you know, if it's something that I can answer in the comments, I'll do that too. I enjoy reading comments and answering questions, so certainly feel free. All right, that's that. I'm gonna keep working, but I will let you go because there's no point in you hanging around watching me do the same thing over and over and over again for hours on end. All right, see you guys later. Bye.